Should you pull for Violet? Today, we are going to help you answer that question. We're going to take a look at his kit, see where and how to use him, how to gear him, and see if he is worth it to you. Violet is a 5-star Earth Thief. His S1 is Graceful Cut. He attacks the enemy with a chance to inflict decreased attack for one turn. When it is not the caster's turn, this attack will increase his CR by 15% and gain 2 focus instead of 1. The S2 is Dual Accepted. He eats an apple which dispels 2 debuffs and grants perception for 3 turns before recovering a bit of HP and granting himself an extra turn. And finally, the S3 is Butterfly Cut. He consumes all focus and attacks the enemy, dealing damage proportional to the amount of focus consumed. When 5 focus is consumed, it will reset the cooldown of the S3. When the S3 is off cooldown, so when it is available, he gets 35% evasion. Not only that, after he successfully evades an attack, he will also counterattack with the S1. So now that we know his kit, let's talk about the strengths within it. The S1 alone doesn't do much when used on his turn, but on a dual attack or a counter attack, it will push the CR by 15% and gain 2 focus, which is actually pretty huge. The S2 grants perception, which makes him easier to gear because perception grants 15% crit chance and crit damage. Then the S2 also cleanses 2 debuffs before giving him a little heal. The S3 is the skill that makes Violet such a broken hero because, as mentioned, when the skill is off cooldown, he gets an extra 35% evasion, a counterattack upon evading, then gets the bonus from the S1. And because of the reset on the S3, he can keep this skill up at all times, which pretty much makes it a permanent evasion unless he gets reset by the enemy or you screw up your rotation. A single counter followed up by an apple allows him to open up with a fully charged butterfly cut, which does some pretty good damage. Now with the correct artifact, Violet will have over 100% evasion against ice heroes, making him nearly invincible to them. And also with the correct gear set, he can potentially 1v4 an entire team, and I'm sure most of you guys out there have already seen this happen. And now that we know his strengths, what are his weaknesses? One of his weaknesses is that he can't really do much if you aren't attacking him, because he is unable to counter to push his own CR and gain more focus. Though saving him as a last target could be a very fatal mistake, so if you plan on doing that, I really hope that you have a game plan. Another thing is that he only has single target attacks, though these days this could be seen as a strength because he can better utilize the pen set gear. But as with all single target heroes, he's going to have issues fighting against stealth heroes, though he can counter attack stealth heroes to get rid of them, unless that hero is S10A because their S1 is uncounterable. Heroes with extra hit chance really mess him up as well, as they are becoming more and more common throughout new heroes, buffs, and artifacts. Just a way to fix the Violet problem without actually nerfing him, right? Blind and unhealable debuffs also mess him up if he can't apple to cleanse it, because this won't allow him to heal up on his counterattacks, given he is on a lifesteal set. Fire heroes are some of the best counters to him, not because they have extra hit chance on grass heroes, but simply because they are going to be harder for Violet to kill, so they kind of fight on equal grounds in terms of mischance. Now his counter mechanic can be exploited by certain heroes who want to be hit, such as a Crow, who can purposefully reduce his own HP for a stronger horse, a Carrot, who will burn her victims when hit, but also cleanses and grants herself a barrier, Charlotte will grant herself a defense and attack buff when hit, G-Purgus will push the entire team, Ravi will stack her passive faster when she's hit, Senya will deal damage back if she isn't crit, Rowana will heal and push the entire team, a Tywin will cleanse the team, and Rowlett will stack focus if he dodges. I'm sure there are more out there as well. But even with such a long list of weaknesses, Violet is still insanely strong because it requires very specific heroes or RNG to be able to take him down. So now where do we use Violet? He doesn't really do much in terms of PvE, where you can't find someone else to better take his spot. But in terms of PvP, this is where he is pretty much a god. Even though Violet does work in arena offense, I don't recommend him here because he just takes way too long to do the job. But in every other aspect of PvP, he is a complete monster. In arena defense, he helps prevent cleaves, but also makes the opponent think twice about using an ice hero. Same with Guild War defense. Then in offense, if you see an ice hero on the defense, you can easily exploit them by throwing a Violet into the mix. World Arena is self-explanatory. I'm sure anyone who's done RTA at some point has experienced a 1v4 by the RNG god himself. So now you want to know, how do I build my own 1v4 monster? The first build here is what I personally use on my Violet. It relies more heavily on RNG than the next build does. You will need a lifesteal set. You can go with a crit sub if you need the stats, but if you don't, then a pen set would be the better choice. The stats for this build focus more heavily on damage. You want to push in a lot of attack and crit damage. You can max the crit chance at 85% because perception will grant him 15%, which he should be able to keep up at all times. Speed is not something you need to worry about because he pushes his own CR every time he counters. The more speed, the better, but I would not make it a priority. Then you want to put a little bit of health and defense in there so he can try to survive one or two full-on hits before he gets wrecked. As for artifacts, I do recommend MLDB over everything else. This allows him to always counter with an attack buff up. Though Violet Talisman is a close second because this does grant him extra attack stats, which stack on top of the attack buff, but this also allows him to stack up to 30% extra evasion, unlike the 20% from the MLDB. That is if you have a max limit broken talisman though. Shepherds of the Hollow pulls in third because it is genuinely a good artifact. It's just harder to acquire and max because it's a 5-star artifact, while MLDB is just a simple 4-star artifact. Then we end it with Shepherds of Chaos. This grants the best survival properties out of all the artifacts, but just because it doesn't have any offensive properties, it's not as popular. Now this next build is a tanky build. I do feel that this setup is better than the last one, and I will explain why in a little bit here. Again, you will need a lifesteal set. I cannot recommend that anybody build a Violet without a lifesteal set. This is what gives him the sustain, allowing him to be such a freaking god. And for the stats, we can take the damage numbers down a bit and pump more of it into the health and defense. As always, I recommend a decent amount of defense for lifesteal heroes as it just scales better. And speaking of scaling, this is why I do think the tanky build is better than the last build. Having a tanky Violet will allow him to survive more hits if RNG does not want to swing your way, but because of the World Arena Frenzy, this gives him a big advantage over the last build because he will become stronger and stronger while also be able to maintain some of the bulk. For artifacts, there is no change from the last build. I also cannot recommend that anybody use an artifact that does not come with extra evasion. This is what makes Violet who he is. And now, my final thoughts on Violet. In PvE, he's pretty much garbage and has no place in hunts or expeditions, though you might be able to find a place for him in a random abyss floor, and he does actually work quite well in the tower, though I really don't think that's any reason to pull any hero. The real reason to pull Violet is PvP. This is where Violet is an absolute god. In Arena, I gave him a 9.3 rating, even though I said I don't recommend him on offense, but because he's such an annoyance and deterrent on defense, I had to give him a high rating. In Guild Wars, I'm sure half the towers in every war has a Violet in it, and there's a very clear reason as to why. Then in World Arena, he might not be the must ban like he was before AOL, Balian, Rimuru, and the A-Ravi buff, but he's still a pretty horrible hero to deal with. The ROI on Violet is nothing short of worth. He is actually a completely usable hero with only 3 molas. The effect percentage on the S1 is pretty much garbage because no one builds a Violet with effectiveness, and it's only a 1 turn debuff anyways. The cooldown on the S3 does not matter at all because you should not be using the S3 if you do not have 5 focus to proc the reset. But if you want to use him properly to his max potential, I do highly recommend that you push him to plus 15. You will not regret it. The gear quality needed for your Violet to really shine is decently high. Without good gear, your Violet won't survive multiple hits, and not only that, he might not be able to do enough damage to sustain himself. The emotional investment though, I am confident to say that you can invest in him without needing to worry about his future. No matter how many heroes they decide to release to counter him, he is still a complete monster against 95% of all ice heroes, which is 20% of all heroes in the game, and for the next 60% of heroes, he fights them all with an advantage. Unless a miracle happens and they decide to start nerfing heroes, Violet will always be a force to be reckoned with. And now moving on to the Husbando rating. For his design, I actually hated it. I pulled a Violet on his banner while secretly hoping I would get a different hero. Mind you, this was back before Pity was implemented into the hero banners, which allowed you to pull off banner heroes. I never even built my Violet because I disliked his look so much. I only finally built him because of the buff. but I really do love his skin. It completely changes his look and his attitude, so I gave him a decent rating. But then, would I protect his smile? I actually would. Seeing his relationship with Luluka play out throughout the main and side stories, you really can't help but to love this duo, especially because protecting Violet would also mean you are protecting Luluka's smile. And now, will it daddy? Yeah, I wrote daddy instead of husbando because I just couldn't fit the word husbando into the space given. Now, I gave this a very high rating because watching his interactions with Luluka, it's just so freaking cute and heartwarming. Even though he can pull tons of tail, he still stays true to Luluka, and he's a grapehead you really can't help but to fall in love with. So now finally, the answer you've already known, the answer you weren't really waiting for. But is Violet worth the pull? The answer is obvious and it is a yes. I think if there's anyone in this game that is a must pull for PvP, I would say it's Violet. The only reason you wouldn't want to pull for Violet is if you've sworn not to play with husbandos or if you don't do any PvP whatsoever. There's nobody else in this game that can fill his role in PvP. The sheer amount of PTSD we've all experienced from getting 1v4 or the maniacal laughter we've all let out when we managed to win a 1v4 with him, he really is something special. So if you want more guides, check out that playlist right over there, or maybe this video right above my freaking face. But I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, please like and subscribe. Thank you for hanging out with us, and I'll see you guys next time, man. Bye.